We've seen this picture a few times. Let's talk about how our algorithm is going to change. So what we're going to do is, you know, user makes a request. We go to the database. We run the query. We get the results out. We store them in the cache. And then we return the HTML to the user. That's kind of our standard use case. And then any future requests hit ASCII-CHAN, bounce off the cache, and come back. Now, we're going to improve the situation a little bit so that when you do a database write, so we post a new piece of art, and we do our write to the database. At the same time, we're going to clear our cache so that after we redirect the user to the front page, and the user fetches slash again, we're going to run our query. We're going to get our result. We're going to recache the new version, which has, you know, multiple things in it, and then return correct HTML to our user. So let's go ahead and see how that looks in the code. OK, now, despite the complexity of that picture, this is actually a fairly easy change. Our rendering front page doesn't change at all. And our top arts function that runs the cache database query, this also doesn't change at all. The only thing that's going to change is that when we submit new art, which is in this function here, the post function, you know, after we put this art in the database, let's just clear our cache, which looks something like this, cache.clear. Clear is a function on Python dictionaries that just basically empties the dictionary. In our case, this will work just fine because we're only storing one thing in the cache, so it's fine to just delete everything. Alternatively, of course, we could have just said cache, you know, top equals none, something like that, but let's go with the simple solution for now. Okay, so let's see how this works. So here we are. I'm going to reload our front page of ASCII-CHAN. We see our beer is here now because I changed the app, so our cache got cleared anyway. If we go to our terminal, we see that our most recent request did a database query. And if I go back to ASCII-CHAN, reload the page again, and then go back to our terminal, we can see that our most recent request did not make a DB query. So that's pretty cool. So our caching is still working on the front page. Now let's submit a new piece of art to ASCII-CHAN and see if the site still works. I'm going to put a few blank lines here so we can see where we were when we come back to this. OK, so here we are in ASCII-CHAN. Let's go ahead and submit a new piece of art. In this case, it's going to be a cake. Now, what should happen is we're going to store this in the database, clear the cache, reload the page, update the cache, and have our new piece of cake. OK, so I submitted, and now we see our cake is here. Let's go ahead and look at our terminal to see all these requests. OK, so we can see our post here. That was the submission. And then we responded with the 302, which is the redirect. And then we can see we print out DB query. And we see our front page request, and all is well. Now, if I were to reload our page again, here we go, and go back to the terminal, we'd see that the follow-up request didn't hit the database. So now we've got this cool system. When we submit to the database, we clear the cache. And then the next time we hit the front page, we rerun the query. And every page after that doesn't hit the database anymore. So now we're doing only as many database queries as we actually need. And so every user to ASCII-CHAN won't have to hit the database unless there's a new submission for them. This is going to cut down on our database requests substantially. You know, instead of doing one database read on every page view, we're only doing one database read on every submission, which happens far less frequently. OK, so we implemented our new algorithm. And before, in the original algorithm, we were doing one DB read per page view. This is really bad. You know, this is doing a lot of unnecessary database reads. The name of the game when you're scaling websites is only do the minimum number of database operations that you need to. And in this case, one read per page view is the opposite of that. After our solution, we're only doing one DB read per submission. And since submissions are rare, you know, most of our users, you know, the vast majority of them aren't submitting new content, they're just reading content, we've cut down the number of database operations we're doing significantly. So when you're looking for speed and you're looking for efficiency and you're looking to not spend all of your money paying for database access, this is a much better approach than this one. You know, if we're getting 1,000 page views a day and 10 submissions a day, we went from 1,000 DB reads to 10. That's a big improvement. And those are actually approximately the real numbers from ASCII-CHAN. So, you know, we just saved Steve a bunch of coin here. So good job, everybody.